Sir, the Honorable Minister has moved this bill, the amendments to the Collection of Statistics Act 2008, on the grounds that there is a legislative vacuum. Sir, I was trying to understand, what is this legislative vacuum? This bill extends an act passed by Parliament in 2008 to Jammu and Kashmir. Perfectly in order. But it extends this new legislation to the items in the union list for which there is this so-called legislative vacuum. Sir, there are 97 items in the union list of the 7th schedule. And I find it extraordinarily difficult to understand what the difficulties are in getting data on each of these 97 items. And I would like the Honorable Minister to take one or two examples in his reply and enlighten us on what exactly was the legislative vacuum and why data on each of these or some of these 97 items. For example, one of the 97 is census. Census has been going on in Jammu and Kashmir. So I really failed to understand what the difficulty was, and I'm perfectly willing to be educated by the minister who's been a law minister previously as to why the previous act failed in getting the information on these 97 items. So there is a certain process, certain procedure, certain constitutional all that is followed insofar as acts by Parliament are passed and their applicability to Jammu and Kashmir. The UPA government passed the Collection of Statistics Act. It was passed in 2009. It was the Collection of Statistics Act 2008. So subsequently, the Jammu and Kashmir Assembly passed the Jammu and Kashmir Collection of Statistics Act 2010. That's the normal procedure that we adopt because of the special nature that Jammu and Kashmir enjoys. Sir, but I do want to make one point here, because there is a generally widely held belief that Article 370 is something unique in the Constitution of India and that exists for no other state. So I'd like to remind ourselves that in addition to Article 370, we have Article 371 that applies to certain areas of Gujarat and Maharashtra. We have Article 371A that applies to Nagaland, 371B that applies to Assam, 371C that applies to Manipur, 371D and E that applied to the undivided state of Andhra and now applies to the states of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, 371F that applies to Sikkim, 371G that applies to Mizoram, 371H that applies to Arunachal Pradesh, 371I that applies to Goa, and finally 371J that applies to certain parts of Karnataka. So this myth, the mythology that has been created, the political mythology that has been created around 370 needs to be understood in the larger perspective of the special provisions that have been provided in the Constitution for other parts of the country in addition to Jammu and Kashmir. So, I took the liberty of speaking to the Finance Minister of Jammu and Kashmir, and I asked him whether he was aware that this bill was coming. The Finance Minister, who is the architect of the BJP-PDP coalition, told me that yes, he was aware that the Lok Sabha had passed this bill, but he was not aware of this bill when it was introduced in the Lok Sabha. Sir, I find this truly amazing. We are passing a law specifically for the state of Jammu and Kashmir, which has a special political history. The government is in coalition in Jammu and Kashmir, and the coalition government, the finance minister of the coalition government tells me that he was not aware of the government's move till the bill was passed in the Lok Sabha. So I'd like the Honorable Minister to kindly explain to us whether the state government was on board as far as this legislation is concerned, and what the state government believed were the deficiencies in not only the Collection of Statistics Act 2008, but also the Jammu and Kashmir Collection of Statistics Act of 2010. So I am not nitpicking here. I say this deliberately because the atmosphere, the environment in Jammu and Kashmir is very sensitive. And we need to understand this sensitivity. And we should not be seen to be doing something unilaterally without taking an elected government on board, of which the ruling party is itself a part of the coalition in the state. So I find this somewhat puzzling to understand. So there are other one or two small provisions in the bill, like appointment of nodal officers and so on, which are required to implement the law more effectively. But the crux of this bill relates to Jammu and Kashmir. And that is why I have raised this issue of non-consultation with the state government before bringing forward this bill, and also the complete mystery as to why this bill had to be brought 7 years after Parliament has passed an act. Was there such a huge gap in statistics? Which statistics? Economic statistics? Social indicators? Environmental indicators? A large number of indicators were mentioned in the original act, in the principal act. And I would like to know from the Honorable Minister whether governance in the state or governance at the center has suffered on account of the lack of collection of those statistics. Sir, I do not want to ascribe any motives to the government, but I do not want legislative vacuum to become a cloak for some other purpose of extending acts passed by Parliament to Jammu and Kashmir without recognizing the sensitivity of the situation that prevails there. Right. So subject to these two questions that I have asked, we have no problem supporting this bill.
Thank you very much, Sri Jairam Ramesh.